So what we're going to do is we're going to first set up our embroidery hoops, and I'm going to show you how to do that in case you've never done this before. Okay, so if you notice, your embroidery hoop has these two rings, right? One ring is slightly smaller than the other, a slightly bigger ring at the top that you can use to make the ring loose or tight, and it helps to loosen the ring out before we put the fabric through. So you might have like a different kind of mechanic. It might not be exactly like this, okay? So we're going to make this nice and loose. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my smaller hoop and I'm going to place it on a surface or the table. And I'm going to put my fabric on top of that. And then I'm going to take my bigger hoop and I'm just going to push it over the fabric and the smaller hoop that's inside. Okay, so it should easily fit like that. So this is what it ends up looking like. You have your fabric that's in the middle of these two hoops. Okay, this is what it should look at the back. Once you've done that, you can just tighten this so that the fabric stays nice and stretched. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you first on a piece of paper how we're going to draw outline for our rows. Okay, so again, if you're doing this for the first time, it might be helpful to just do it on a plain piece of paper before you do it on the fabric. Okay, so we're going to draw the outline of the rows. I'm going to show you how you build that, and then we're going to draw the same thing on the fabric and then start stitching. All right. Okay, let's do that. So to start off with, you've got to choose the size of the rows you'd like. If you have like a really small coin lying around anywhere, or a small circular object, or even like, you know, the cap of a pen that's circular, you can use that as a stencil, or just make some, you know, round shapes like that. You can try doing slightly bigger ones. Just get comfortable with drawing some nice circles. Yes, we're starting on paper first, just to practice the design so that, you know, when we do it in the fabric, then we don't have to erase it out later. Okay, so just keep practicing drawing a few circles. Just get a hang of it, take some time. Okay, so you can see my circles are getting a little better. All right, so once you've made the perfect circle, or however happy you are with your circle, it doesn't have to be perfect. Once you've made your circle, what you're going to do is you're going to make a dot right in the middle of it. Okay, so you're going to make a dot right in the middle. And now we're going to draw 5 lines from this dot to the outline of the circle at equal distances. Okay, that might sound complicated, but we're going to practice drawing it a few times and I'm sure you'll get a hang of it. Okay, so we're going to draw 5 lines. If we do 3 or we do 6 or we do 4, the rows doesn't work. Okay, it has to be 5 lines. So that's really important. The number 5, I'm just going to write it here on the corner so you remember. Okay, so the number 5 is really important. We're going to draw 5 lines. So we're going to start at the center and we can just start with 1 here. And the second, and the third, fourth, and the fifth. Okay, so it should look something like that. Now it doesn't have to be exactly, you know, the spaces don't have to be exactly the same. You can try keeping it as similar to each other as possible, but it's okay if one is slightly bigger than the other. Okay, it takes a little bit of practice. Okay, if you wanted to do a much smaller rows, you could do the same thing. Just draw a smaller circle. Okay, center 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Once you're comfortable with this, we're going to draw this same stencil on our fabric now. Okay, so keep that aside or keep it next to you for reference and get your fabric ready. Now we're going to draw that same circle, the same pizza. Let's just call it a pizza on our fabric now. Okay. So make a circle, center point right in the middle, 5 lines. Okay, cool. I'm going to do another one slightly smaller. A point in the middle, 5 lines. All right, and one last one so that we can do 3 roses for practice, slightly bigger. And again, point in the middle and 5 lines. Okay, so now our stencil is ready. So what we're going to do now is we're going to thread our needle. So I have a bright orange and a blue here, and I think I'm going to go for the orange, maybe for the smaller ones, and I'll use the blue for the slightly bigger ones. Okay, so I'm going to start with the big rows, and I'm just going to pull my thread out a little bit. Now for the rows, it's really important that we first start with like a slightly smaller piece of thread. Okay, so we're going to start with a slightly smaller piece of thread, and later we're going to use a longer one. So we can start with the smaller piece of thread now. For those of y'all who would like to see how I thread the needle, I make sure the thread is nice and all the strands of thread are nice and together. And then I really carefully just pass them through the needle. And I'm just going to pull just a little bit, not too much. And I'm going to tie a knot at the end. I'm going to start with the big one. You can do it on the small one as well. It's the same process. Okay. So what we're going to do now is we're going to make 5 straight lines with the thread. Okay. What we're going to do is we're going to stitch 5 lines across the lines that we've drawn on our fabric. Okay. So we're going to start with bringing our needle out from the back. So bring your needle out from the back, right at the center where you made that point. Okay. Can you see how it's at the center? So bring your needle out. And then you're going to poke your needle straight into the fabric at the end of any one line. Okay, so just put it there. Make sure it touches the outline of your circle like that. Now we're going to do the same thing. We're going to come towards the outline of the next line. All right, on the outline of the circle. And we're going to bring our thread out and we're going to poke it right in the middle. So like we created that star with the pencil, we're basically just covering it up with thread now, okay? And making sure that we have these loops, except they're not loops because we're nicely pulling them down. So it's nice and flat, right? So it's like a single stitch like that, but we're gonna do 5 single stitches. So let me show you how to do that again. Bring your needle to the edge of the circle at the next line, and straight into the middle again. You keep turning your hoop around, that might help. And do the same thing, bring your needle out at the edge of the circle on the next line and push it back to the center. And one last time. And push it into the center again. Okay, that's it. So this is what it would look like at the back. Yours might look different, but that's okay. All right. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to tie a knot here because we're done using the thread for now. All right. So we're going to tie a knot now. The way I tie the knot is I put my needle under an existing stitch at the back. And you see the loop that's getting created? Just pass the needle through that loop and pull. Okay. And again, it's always good to double knot. In this case, I think I triple knotted. Okay. Cool. And then once you're done with that, you can just cut that out. So we're going to do our next step now. Now is when the rows really comes together. Okay, are you all ready for this next step? So for the next part, what we're going to do is we're going to need a slightly longer piece of thread. All right, what we're going to do now is actually make the rows. And this might seem a little complicated at first, but the more we do it, the more easy it's going to get. Okay, so just try paying close attention, maybe just for the first rows. And then you can start doing it on your own. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to bring my needle out. And you can bring your needle out on either side. I'm going to bring it out here, very close to the center. Okay. I'm just bringing out my needle here, super close to the center. And I'm just going to pull my thread up. Okay. Now, the fun part about this row is that we no longer have to pass the needle through the fabric. We're just going to keep spinning the thread around like a spider. All right, so this stitch is actually called a spider's web stitch, and the reason is because we're just going to go over and under and over and under those 5 lines that we've made. Okay, and before we do that, I'm actually just going to show it to you on paper so that makes a little bit of sense. Okay, so when we have our circle with the 5 lines, and if our thread is over here, we're going to go over this thread and then under this thread and then over and under and over. And we're just going to keep doing that till we reach the outside outline of the rose, and then we're going to tie a knot, okay? So it'll make sense once we start doing it. So we've pulled our thread out really close to where the middle is. And now I'm going to go over this line of thread that's closest to me. So when I say I'm going to go over it, that means my thread is going to go over it and my needle is going to go under the next one. So we're going to leave a line and the needle is going to go under the next line of thread, okay? So like that. So my thread is here. So I'm going to leave this line. I'm leaving this line and I'm going to go under this one like that. And I'm just going to gently pull my thread. And I'm going to do the same thing now. Okay, I'm going to leave this one and I'm going to go under the next one. Okay, and I'm going to keep doing the same thing. I'm going to leave this one and go under this one. And I'm going to keep pulling the thread. So if you notice, it's kind of slowly forming this little coil in the center. And that's what we've just got to keep creating till the coil comes all the outside outline of the circle. So we went under that one, so we're going to skip this one and go under the next. And just pull gently. Okay, there we are, we're here. So we're going to skip the next one and go under the next. So you're just going to keep leaving every other line, every alternate line, and just keep going under the next one, the next line of thread. Again, we're leaving this one and we're going under this one. So it's like an over, under, and just keep doing the same thing. If you're a bit confused about how we're doing this, I'm going to do another two roses. So don't worry about it. I'm just going to take this one really slow so you can just observe and get a hang of it. And then if you want, you can start with me on the next rose. You see how the tiny little rose is coming together in the middle? So we're going to keep doing the same thing till we reach the outline. Okay, now you can see a little bit more how it's forming. There we have it. Our rose is looking cute. So like you can see, I'm just doing the same thing over and over again till the rose just starts forming itself, okay? And I'm not pulling the thread too tight, because if I pull the thread too tight, then the thread will just scrunch up, and we don't want that. We want the thread to be nice and loose so that it just forms this really pretty rose shape. Then you can keep pushing the sides out like that a little bit. Okay, so if you notice, I'm coming closer to the outline of my circle, and I'm just going to keep going till I can no longer see my pencil marks. That's a good measure to keep in mind about when to stop. As soon as your pencil marks are covered, that's when you know that your rose is ready. Okay, so now when you start coming closer to the outline of your rose, see that rose, how cute it's looking, okay? You might notice that some of the lines are getting harder to see, okay? So sometimes it could be helpful to just slightly, you know, push the rose aside a little bit to see where the thread is, because we still have a little bit of work to go on this side. I hope you can see that. But this side is kind of almost done. So I'm going to keep going around it just maybe another two or three times. Even if I can see a little bit of pencil, that's okay. But just make sure that you don't miss a line, because if you do, then you might be pushing too much thread on the outline, and that won't really help the rose to sit in its place, for the stitches to sit in its place. Okay? So just keep an eye on that, if that makes sense. Okay, I think this is a good point for me to stop, because I'm quite pleased with this rose. That's how it should start looking. A really nice big rose. If you've done a smaller one, you've probably finished already. But if you've done a little bigger one, then that just takes a little bit of time sometimes. That's it. That's how we make roses. And once you get really comfortable with it, you can start doing so many, right? And add some leaves. I also wanted to show you these pair of pants that I have, and I've added little roses along the pockets here. And this is like a really fun way to add some embroidery to your clothes.